Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. Thank you for being here. This is Andrew coming to you from beautiful Costa Rica. Today's topic is when the narcissist spies on you. Think about that one for a minute. It's gonna be a good one. Guys, remember, if you like the content, please subscribe. Let's dig right into this. When the narcissist spies on you. Now, we talk about the flying monkeys and we talk about everything. Sorry. We talk about everything the narcissist does, the Hoovers and or maybe not. Maybe they just, they're gone. You know, they've disappeared out of your life, which is the best thing. That's what you need. You need them to be gone from your life forever. And I know you've blocked them every way possible, just like me. So that's beautiful. But we talk about in the channel, like you, the empath, and the person maybe that was discarded, maybe you peeking on their social media, and maybe you doing some things, you know, because you think you're strong enough. You know, I can test this. I'm good. I can handle this. And let's be real, you probably can't. And you're just, what you're going to do is, let's say you unblock them on social, as an example. And then you do that, and then you see some pictures, and you're like, oh my God, it breaks your heart all over again. And you go backwards 20 steps. Now, it happens, that's what people do, and it's natural. I'm suggesting you never do that. Honestly, I've never done it once, I'm not going to be doing it now. But I'm just saying to you, it happens, that's what people do. And then eventually you understand, you learn. You see, you have to learn that lesson pretty much on your own. I can tell you all day long, or suggest to you all day long, don't check on them on social media, but it's up to you to ultimately make the decision. But we're gonna flip the coin now, and the coin's gonna be this way. What about if the narcissist is checking on your social media or what you're doing and things like that? Like I mentioned before, we know about the flying monkeys. The flying monkeys' sole purpose is to be little minions and little trolls and report back to the narcissist about your updates, how you're looking, what you're doing, if you're healthy, if you're strong enough for a Hoover, all those kind of things. Keep in mind, the flying monkeys don't even know that the narcissist is a narcissist. They just have no lives. So that what they do is they fuel the narcissist not only with supply, but with updates on your whereabouts and what you're doing. Now, keep in mind, peeking on people's social media is a two-way street. You can do it or it can be done to you. It doesn't need to always be about you and my suggestions on this channel to not do so. And by the way, you shouldn't. But the narcissist is fully capable of this also. You know, the narcissist can create dummy accounts just like other people can. And the narcissist doesn't necessarily need to use flying monkeys, although they are the number one way the narcissist gets information. But the narcissist easily can just, drive by your house, suddenly show up somewhere and just maybe you go to a softball game a couple times a week and they just show up there, but they hadn't been there before. Things like that. You could say it's a Hoover. Sure it is, of course. But with the social media and things like that, the narcissist, although they are a creature, they still need supply and they still do wonder about you. Believe me, they wonder about you. Because what you need to understand is when the narcissistic relationship is over, it's ended, goodbye, sayonara, no more, no mas. What happens is the narcissist sincerely believes that they own you. They do. They believe that they had you once and they can have you again whenever they want to. And that means tomorrow, in 3 days, in a year, in 15 years. Why would they think this? Because they don't think like we think. They don't understand that a relationship which we thought was healthy actually wasn't healthy, and we ended it, or it ended, and we moved on, and we grew, and we developed, and we became educated, and we understand. The narcissist did none of the above. They don't know what a healthy relationship is. They certainly didn't heal after the relationship ended. What they did is they found new supply, or the supply they were grooming while you were in the relationship, and they just tapped into that. Let's plug this one in and let's get as much supply from them as we can. And they have multiple sources of supply, as we know. So the narcissist may be sensing, okay, you're getting stronger. Or maybe they don't even think that way. Watch this one. Maybe it's a couple years from now and you're totally healed, or as healed as you can be, which yes, let's say totally. And let's say you even move to a different part of the world or the country, whatever. And your name pops up in the narcissist head somehow. Like, I don't know, maybe it's one of these reminders on a social media platform, or maybe it's someone says, hey, whatever happened with so-and-so, which is you. And then all of a sudden the narcissist, their radar goes back, oh my God, I forgot about that person. Because you see, the narcissist is always out of sight, out of mind. Meaning, if you are in their sight, if you're right around them, you're a great source of supply. But if you're out, They're just like so childish. It's the object constancy thing. If you're not around, they just don't think of you. Most times, they don't. But your name popped up, and then all of a sudden they're like, oh yeah, what about that person? I forgot. I wonder how they're doing. Boom. They can start spying on you just like you could have to them. Remember, guys, I'm telling you, I'm suggesting, don't be spying on these people. Leave them alone. Move on. Move forward. Block them. Get them out of your lives forever. These are toxic individuals. But the narcissist, you see, they have a great memory. They know how to push your buttons, how to control you, how to get from you whatever it is that they want, because they remembered what worked with you last time. Sure, maybe time's gone by, maybe it's been 3 years, maybe 10, maybe 20, but they remember every little detail about you and about what makes you tick. And they're willing to bank that, you know what, you haven't changed that much. Sure, you've probably aged, well, you have aged, sorry, but on top of that, they're like, you know, I can still do this. And that source of supply, which is you, wow, that was a good one. I had that for a long time, and I really, really abused that person. And you know what? They'll probably go for it again, because they're probably still attached to me in some capacity. Or if I show up, maybe I can get that old sentimental feeling again. You know, you get my point. Not from them, but from you. So they're banking on this, because they do believe that they own you. Yes, they do. Now, do they own you? Absolutely not. Nobody owns anybody. But most importantly, after the narcissistic relationship, we've healed. We're learning, we're growing. We invested time into ourselves. That's why you're on this channel. You're investing time, you're spending it wisely. You're not sitting around on your smartphone digging up sources of supply that are gonna keep you going for the next 10, 12 hours or week or two. You don't need to do that. You see, you're healthy, you're beautiful. You can do whatever you want to as a solo individual, as a, like just being alone, you're fine. You don't need people. You don't need someone. You certainly don't need a narcissist. The narcissist needs you. They need you more than you'll ever, ever know. Getting back on track, the narcissist is fully capable of spying on their own also, not just with flying monkeys. And they're very capable of doing this at any moment, at any time. Think though, do you actually believe that you, after your relationship, would allow them to enter your life in any capacity? You wouldn't. I wouldn't. And if you even think 1% of you would be like, yeah, I think I would, you still have work to do. You still have an awful lot of work to do. The reason I'm telling you that is if you leave the door open even a sliver, just a crack, a little bit, and that little gust of wind pushes the door open more, and the narcissist somehow gets a hold of you, and you, in a moment of weakness, say, yeah, you know what? I'm gonna grab that cup of coffee. Let's go. I'm strong enough. I can handle this. I'm educated and I'm empowered. I can do this. And let's say you do that and you go and you have the coffee and the narcissist puts on that charm all over again. Only this time it's stronger and you're like, oh my God, I really missed this. This is unbelievable. Like, wow. Okay. I think things are getting better now. No, they're not. That's just a snake in clothing. All it is someone trying to manipulate you again and have you fall for their tricks. Deceitful, lying, manipulating parasite, which is the narcissist. That's what they're doing. So why am I saying this? I'm saying this because don't leave that door cracked open a little bit. Don't see them, don't contact them, block them every way possible. We're human beings and we make mistakes and we're allowed to do that. As long as we learn from our mistakes, we will always be making progress. You and myself should have learned from your mistakes with the narcissist. You should have had enough difficult times post-narcissistic relationship ending to understand you never want to do that again, ever. So this video is a reminder for you. The narcissist, they can spy on you, and they can, and they probably are in some capacity. Wherever you are on the planet, if you're accessible, believe me, there's a very good chance that they're keeping tabs on you. And many of you, please drop comments if you know what I'm talking about. Now, we're all in different situations, locations, cities, towns, countries, but we're all on the planet. And it's now easier today, more than ever, to connect with people. We know it. Like you're watching this video, probably from, I'm guessing, over 30 different countries right now, and I'm in Costa Rica, let's be real. How many of you guys have been here? Probably not many. It's beautiful though. You should really come, it's absolutely gorgeous. But getting back on track, the narcissist don't think that when the relationship ends, it's only you who feels like you need a peek at their social media and only you have those feelings. No, believe me, I know they turn the page and they don't look back, but in the back of their mind, when they get a little triggered, they're like, yeah, I remember that person. Oh my God. Yeah. And they will check up on you to see if your tank is full again and to see if you'll go for round two, round three, even more. Don't allow it to happen. Continue to be vigilant, strong, courageous, insightful, determined, and committed to being the best version of you possible. Don't allow the narcissist any cracks in the door, meaning don't let the door open even a little bit, because they will push it open. And you never know in a moment of weakness. So this, again, is a message of beauty, of hope, inspiration, power, commitment, development, empowerment. I just want to remind you that the narcissist, although they are creatures, in my opinion, I mean, they're human beings as well, but they're nothing like us empaths, but they too, they have a little sliver of themselves of curiosity about you, about how you've healed, about what you're doing, who you're with, all these kind of things. So guys, I'm going to end the video right now. I hope you liked it. I love doing it. From beautiful Costa Rica, this is Andrew. I'll talk to you soon. Namaste. God bless you, and I'll talk to you soon. Bye-bye.